one of those days my chicken didn't thaw, so trying to figure out what I'm gonna eat. I have an acorn squash, and I was trying to figure out what I was gonna do with that. And then I had an idea. I have a little bit of Italian sausage in the freezer. I think I'm going to roast. I'm gonna like go ahead and get this. I know I should roast my seeds. It never works out for me. They're always burnt or weird. Anyway, I'm gonna get this, season it, prick it, start the cooking process, and then I'm gonna do a mixture of maybe some farro, some Italian sausage. I gotta see what vegetables I have in there. I have to play with that a little bit to see what I'm gonna mix in, so I'll keep you posted. But hopefully this turns out well. I'm gonna eat it regardless, so we're gonna see. So I'm trying to figure out like what temperature I should roast, and also whether I should roast ahead of time or wait till I stuff it. The downside to stuffing, like waiting till I stuff it, means that I might not cook all the way through. Anyway, so I pull up a recipe. I'm like, okay, you know, I use it as a guide. Mostly I need the temperature, but I stopped reading past the temperature once I realized that they're like, yeah, roast the squash. But at no point was there anything about seasoning said squash. So you're just going to have squash in there. No salt, no pepper, no anything, like nothing. Just, okay, fired. I'm brand new. I, of course, had to be a little extra. So a little salt and pepper, some onion and garlic powder. And then I'm at some salt. Also, since I am, what am I? Oh, I'm gonna be using fresh thyme because I have some in my garden. I also put in a little bit of dried thyme, and so I'm gonna use real garlic in addition to the garlic powder. Let's see, will you both fit in here? Kind of. We're gonna make you both fit in there. I should just use bigger. I'm so hard-headed, but I'm not going to because I don't want to. I'm going to use this little bitty. I'll show you. Yes, it is coming out the side. Yes, I do have a bigger cast iron skillet. No, I'm not going to use it. All right. So now I'm going to see what all is going to go into this, into the middle of this thing. I want to do a grain, I think, so I might parboil a grain and then let it finish cooking like in there. And I might do some cheese. Like I haven't decided what my flavor palette's gonna be in there. Right now it's pretty neutral, so I could go in any number of directions. It's a miracle I didn't use any cumin because that is my happy place, but I refrained. So I'm gonna play around in the kitchen and see like what pops up and see if it's gonna go in the middle of this. I'm very excited all of a sudden. Acorn squash is beautifully tender. I probably could have pulled this out a little bit earlier. I should have parboiled my farro, but I was lazy, and so I have put it in here with the sausage, some fresh thyme, some mushrooms, some garlic, some onion. And then I threw in some water. If I had had some broth, I would have put in some broth. I have some unknown liquid rendering from something that I put in the freezer. It's red. If it were green, I had a green one. That was like me rendering the juice from when I made spanakopita and like wringing all the juice out of the spinach. But you know, it's filled with nutrients and all kinds of stuff, so I froze it. And if it were lighter in complexion, I would assume it was some kind of broth that I had used, like couldn't use at all. As it is, I don't know what that is. You'd think I would just throw it away, but I'm not. Probably one day I'll experiment when I'm feeling bolder. But as it is, I'm gonna let that try and cook down. I wish I had a proper lid. I gotta see if I can find a lid for my cast iron skillet. And that was fitting, because then I could chop the steam, and that would like actually steam some of the farro so that it won't like break my teeth. And then I'm gonna stuff these. I'm gonna mix in some kale and stuff them and seal it and bake it a little bit longer and see what happens. No cheese. I'm going against the cheese on this one. We'll see. I have goat cheese in there. Oh, also to counter the some of the bitterness I've got, like in the kale. I cut up just a little bit of dried apricot. One of the things they mentioned in the recipe that I saw that was questionable because it didn't season the apricot, the dried, the acorn squash, was apple wedges. And I have an apple, but I'm not going to cut a whole apple just for that. So kind of the same vein. They're very, very thin. I don't want it to be an overwhelming flavor of like getting a huge chunk of apricot, but a little like sweetness, which really there should be enough sweetness in the acorn squash. We're going to see. I'm experimenting. Okay, stuffed. I'm about to cover it and then put it in the oven for like another 15 minutes. I did end up putting it in a little grana padana, largely because when I bought it, I was hoping to eat it with honey the way that I did when I was in Italy. That is not good grana padana, so it's got to go someplace. Why not this? Yeah, we'll see how it turns out. I still have some leftover stuffing, so I didn't quite measure that, like gauge it right, but promising. We'll see. I don't know if you can hear that. Voila! I seemed a little bit longer. So we'll see. Let us taste. I think I probably should have upped the salt on the inside of the acorn squash, so whoever was like, "You don't need to flavor that at all," I question you greatly. Yeah, it needs more flavor. The acorn squash needed more. We should have doubled that. Too hot, I had to spit it out. So, has potential. I will make this again. I would cook the farro at least par, which is what I said I should do, but I was lazy and I didn't feel like it because it's late. So I would do that. I would, and probably in broth, I would up the salt and the flavoring in the acorn squash itself. When I bake it or roast it, you know, ahead of time, I would do that. And then maybe it's finished with some lemon. Some acid of some sort. But the acorn squash is smooth. I love that contrasted against the Italian sausage. It's not much Italian sausage. I only picked one link between the whole, like, for the whole thing. I haven't gotten any of the... I got a little bit of cheese. And that's nice. And actually, I could have probably upped that a little bit, and I think this might finally be a little bit of apricot because I didn't get any apricot before. Yeah, so there are some things here. I need to up the seasoning, just I think because it's one of those things you can't really, I can taste a feeling, but I can't really taste how it all is going to come together as it's cooking. You just kind of have to wait. So that's a piece I need to keep in mind, but this is really promising. And I need to, like, to my mom's credit, I need to write this down so I'll remember. At any rate, this is delightful. I hope you have something delightful too.